Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? My apologies for a slightly longer than anticipated absence, but I am finally moved into my new house. Yay! Still getting a little settled in, but I wanted to let you know that there is a really great greatest elongation of Mercury coming up in this weekend into the early part of next week. And so this is a really wonderful time to be able to see the innermost planet, plus a couple other cool things that are going to be happening at the same time as we progress throughout some of the days. So let me show you some of what's going to happen. Now, me personally, I find that the best time to see Mercury is right around 30 to 45 minutes past sunset. That's for me at about 40 degrees north latitude. If you are further north, you may need to wait a little later for that. If you are further south, you might be able to see it a little earlier, just depending on how soon it gets dark for you and when your twilights actually occur. But for most of at least those of us living between, say, 30 and 50 degrees north latitude, you're probably going to be okay in that 30 to 45 minute window. But because Mercury is going to be so high this time, we actually have a little longer. So check this out. We're going to skip ahead to 45 minutes past sunset on May 11th. And as you can see, Mercury is way up here, actually above Venus. Normally it's, you know, below where Venus is. So you have a great opportunity to be able to find kind of even where that and the ecliptic are, because you can watch for Venus and then look for Mars up and to the left towards the west and find Mercury in between there. So let's bring up a few of the lines that we would normally use, and we will look at where the ecliptic is, and then we're actually going to go to the solar system objects section and show the orbits of some of the planets so you can see where Mercury's at. We'll click on Mercury, and then that's just going to show Mercury's here in Stellarium when you're doing this. So on the 11th, and if we bring up our azimuthal grid, we'll be able to see how high up we are. So look at that. Mercury is over 10 degrees high at 45 minutes past. So you've got a really great opportunity. Most anything that's 5 degrees and above, you got a good chance to see. And if it's 10 degrees and above, you really have an excellent shot at observation. You do obviously need a low flat horizon to the west northwest. At least from where I'm at, use your location in Stellarium to determine exactly where you will need to look. This is going to be for me from 40 degrees north latitude. So as we go ahead a couple days, you'll see on the 2nd, the moon actually moves right next to Venus, and it's ridiculously close. It's like less than 1 degree away from Venus, and this does not happen very often. So if we even back up about 15 minutes or so, to about half hour past sunset, you do want to look for this and see if you can get a photo of this, because this is going to be a really, really, really narrow moon. Look at that. Look at how that's just a little teeny tiny sliver. So you can capture that and Venus together, probably see it together in a wide field of view of a telescope, but definitely any kind of telephoto lens that you use, you'll be able to capture both of those and see what you might be able to get. These are going to be low. You're looking at 5 degrees above the horizon. They're going to drop fairly quickly, but that's at least an opportunity. The next day, then the moon gets closer to where Mercury is at, and it gets a little bit larger then too. We can see this and see then you've got a little bit more of a sliver there happening, and then Mercury is about 3 degrees away. And then as we move forward from there, now you can use the moon and Venus to help you find Mercury in case you're lost looking at it early on. Let me take this off and we'll actually center Mercury. There we go. So now between the moon and Venus on the 14th, you can look for Mercury. Now Mercury's still not at greatest elongation. It doesn't get there until the 17th. So you have a number of days, including this weekend, to be able to look for where the planet's at. Look at this. See how it keeps going like this, and then it finally reaches its maximum apex out here in this direction. Now, the great thing about where Mercury is at, You can see how the ecliptic is kind of at maybe a 55, 60 degree angle, but Mercury is actually a little steeper even than that. It's closer to like 65, 70 degrees, so it's even higher in the sky than it would normally be if it were following the plane of the ecliptic. So that pushes it up even higher. It gets a full 22 degrees away from the sun, and we've got it here easily at almost 15 degrees, so the sun is down a good 7 degrees, and you've got the opportunity to see Mercury there at 30 minutes past sunset, and then as you go ahead 15 minutes to that 45-minute mark, it's still at 12 degrees up, and then you've got probably another 15 minutes before you're going to be, you know, close to like even 10 degrees, and you still got time to see it. Now look how dark it's going to be. Venus will be very low, so you're going to see, you may get some of the reports of, hey, what was that blue and green and red flashing over there in the northwest, west-northwest part of the sky? That's Venus as it's starting to rise. It's really bright. It flickers a lot through all that atmosphere. You may get questions about that. That's something that you can talk about with some of your friends. But you also have this really awesome opportunity to see Mercury when it's really dark, because it won't get down into that 5-degree muck until it's, what, wow, at like 9:30 at night. So you have an hour easily to be able to see it. And if we zoom in on this, look what's happening with Mercury. You've got a phase there that you can see, and the size of it, the apparent diameter, is about 8 arc seconds. So that's just a hair smaller than what we really want to try to see, like, say, Mars at. When Mars is reaching opposition, we try to look for 10 arc seconds or larger. So it's pretty close to that. So you should at least be able to see that phase, because a lot of us still look at Mars even when it's at 4, 5, 6 arc seconds across. And very small. So this is a good opportunity. You won't see, likely will not see any features on Mercury, but given how dark it's going to get and how high it will be, I would say crank up that magnification. Hopefully you've got some clear views that direction and you don't get a lot of atmospheric disturbance. And, you know, maybe you'll see something more than just the phase itself. But if you see the phase alone, you're doing extraordinarily well. So we'll back out and see where it's going to go from there. Here we are, and we'll back up to an hour back again so that we're about, you know, a half hour out. And then you'll see how these get closer together. So now you're, you know, into the 21st, 22nd, 23rd, and towards the end of the month, we finally get these two planets meeting on the 28th. So we zoom in here, and they are really, really close together. Look at this. Do that measuring, and you can see that they're just 24 arc minutes apart. So in a 1-degree field of view, you'll be able to frame Venus and Mercury together. And look at what Mercury is doing here. Zoom in on this. It's going to be an even smaller crescent phase. And look at Venus. Venus will be really, really, really bright, so you'll have to kind of be careful with that. But it's mostly kind of the opposite of what Mercury is going to be at. So that's a really great look that you'll have at these planets for the next couple of weeks, but really the next week or so is going to be an awesome time to be able to try to see Mercury. So I hope you get the chance to be able to see that. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.